a few memories of Barry Sheene.
I can remember one of the teachers saying, trouble is with you, Sheene, your whole head's full of motorbikes. Mark my words, you'll never make a living at motorbikes. I didn't realise I was any good until all of a sudden I thought, Christ, I won about 10 races. It's a nice way to earn a living, you know, doing something that you really love.
Barry Sheene, the trademark number 7, and the ability to communicate the exhilaration and dangers of his sport better than any other.
We were just coming up to the point where you get the fastest part and the tyre exploded now. Then it just goes completely sideways. The bike went off the circuit and I went all 200 or 300 yards down the circuit.
First thing I actually remember was the fact that the asphalt was taking a big hole in my leathers, as you can see here. And it tore all the skin off from my shoulder blade and then down my spine and down around here in the kidney area. And that was more or less the only thing that I actually felt. I didn't feel any of the bones breaking.
That was Daytona 1975. And not for the last time, his comeback to racing would be miraculous. By the following season, he'd won his first 500cc world title.
Do you have any ambitions left, really, in motorcycle racing?
Yeah, I want to win it again.
He was just the person that everybody in my business of motorcycling wanted to be.
I knew he would always be tough. If everything was right with him and everything was right with the bike, he was very, very hard to beat. His presence made him stand out.
Every time I read something about you, they talk about you being a man who trains on birds and booze.
No, that's so I'd love to. God, I'd be the first one to admit I'd love to do it. Come up and see me to make me smile.
He was this extrovert guy that had Rolls Royces and helicopters and models as wives and girlfriends.
There was other riders that could go as fast as Barry, but they didn't have his personality.
Of course, I altered my Brute 33.
Go on, Steph, splash it all over.
Which rider won the 350 and 500cc world titles in 5 consecutive years?
Agostini.
1 point.
It's a shark. It's his mouth, look. It's his railings.
Ready, Miss Quattro? Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Barry Sheene.
We were rivals. I mean, I would go out of my way to beat Barry, and he would go out of his way to beat me.
Sheene leads! Barry Sheene goes through! Absolutely together.
Me and Sheene were playing. Every time you get in front, we'd slow down a little bit, and I was trying to get him to go faster.
It's very, very seldom that you see as close a scrap as this.
We were having a lot of fun. Of course, the last 4 or 5 laps, it got very serious. That's where the hand signals came up.
The crowd rises, the crowd roars, and look at that! Barry Sheene waves to Kenny Roberts.
Yeah, only Murray Walker could think that that means you're waving.
And here's Kenny Roberts' answer. Don't you wave at me, young man, because this is what will happen to you. 130 miles an hour. The chicken flag is out. Kenny Roberts and Barry Sheene is gaining. And there is less than a machine's length in it.
I raced very close with Barry because we just trusted each other. He was always good fun, whether we were arguing or fighting, but he was always good fun.
Sheene's Yamaha bike was involved in a crash at 160 miles an hour during practice at Silverstone 4 days before the British Grand Prix.
I came around a very fast left-hand corner at Silverstone. There was an accident the other side of it. I just came merrily over this hill, minding my own business, and ploughed straight into the wreckage.
I can just remember a big ball of flame, and that's about it. And then the next thing I remember is waking up and thinking, my eyebrows feel a bit crispy.
It's almost as if the upper quarter of each tibia had simply exploded. Once we had opened the muscles, the bones just fell apart and we were left with this jigsaw puzzle to sort out.
And I don't think anybody, and I don't even think he thought he'd come back from that one. It was massive. His legs and arms and everything was all busted up, but mentally he wasn't broken at all.
How would you feel getting back onto a bike, do you think?
Happy. Beats being pushed around in a bloody wheelchair.
Body could possibly take it again, but I'm sure that if it's possible, Barry will race again.
Well, Sheene has fought back, clearly determined to prove the doctors wrong and resume his place in one of the world's most dangerous sports. Who are you going to ride for next?
I'm going to ride for Suzuki's now, which is the company that I rode for when I won both the world championships.
The final question is, when will that happen?
My first race will be in March, and I'll go testing in South Africa in February.
Delighted to have you with us. I'm amazed you're here at all. Ladies and gentlemen, Sir Barry Sheene.
He just felt that what he was doing, how he was doing it, the way he was doing it, was the right way. Because he sort of knew in his own mind that he was better than everyone else.
Since the accident, it's been very difficult for me to get a competitive bike, well, one competitive enough to win a world championship. And over the past couple of months, I've been trying to get a good, well, not a good bike, but a bike that I could win the world championship on. And because I couldn't get one, then I thought, well, now was a good time to give it up.
He'd agonized over retirement. A move to four wheels was conspicuously unsuccessful. But his move into broadcasting, especially with Australian television, worked well. The last time we saw Sheene No. 7 in action was the Goodwood Revival meeting just last year.
He was my hero, simple as that.
Be known generally as the best motorcycle racer there's ever been, be the most popular motorcycle racer there's ever been, and do the most for the sport that anyone's ever done. When and if I ever achieve that, then I'd be satisfied.
Barry Sheene, one of the best in absolutely every sense. Okay, join us.